One day we seen e-Yantra Robotics Competition was there. Maybe the very first edition was, it was not as a team event. That time you have to write exams individually. You have to, after writing exams, you have to group together. That was the thing. That time even we don't know how to form team or how to write test. Somehow we written the test. I got through, even I have seen the results after 2 days. There will be a robot sent, you have to form a team. When I come back after to the vacation, I have seen this robot has been accounted in the department's lab, it was a part of, it has been added as a part of lab material. So I was fighting with my HOD, sir, this is for me, sir, it has been given for me, I have a circular, I have permission. Finally, after a great fight, I bought the robot. I don't know to code. To be frank, that time embedded system was like a night miracle, like we don't know nothing in embedded systems. So whatever the, with the examples, everything I, whatever the tutorials and which manuals which are given by e-Yantra, I have read through that and I have coded the full functionality. Whatever program I am doing, it was not doing anything. After classes over, maybe I will sit at 3:30 or 4. I will sit till 9:30, 10. I will be with the robo. Finally, the security will come. He will ask me to go out. Then I will keep the robo, place it in the shelf and I will go back. This was my 2 weeks of effort. So finally, there were some guys who had little knowledge like from diploma. They helped me. Even at final, maybe I had little where to correct, what are the things to correct. That was the knowledge I had while entering into the finals of e-Yantra Robotics that time. Somehow we completed the task and sent a video and we were been selected. So we took the code. I know where to change the parameter, what to change parameter. If this problem comes, I have to change this parameter. If this problem comes, I have to change this parameters. I know the list of problems, list of parameters to change. While traveling, no, from 35 hours of travel from Coimbatore to Mumbai, lot of things will happen in your mind. What are things you have done? What is you are doing? So lot of questions will come. So these questions made me to learn embedded system. So next year I thought I should participate in e-Yantra, that too with my coding. That was the challenge I made on that day, on the first year of e-Yantra Robotics. The next year, the same, we went, and that time I pulled 4 of my teams with my classmates. Next year, even internship was offered, then we went to internship for 6 weeks. Actually, really, that 6 weeks made me what to do next. That made me to think, what are the things or what are the opportunities that IITB has. There are several workshops, even I remember Sudhansarai, professor from Copenhagen, he conducted one entrepreneurship thing. That was the first pitch deck I made it to him. That was my final year project as well. So I took those ideas, I grasped from Kaveriya sir, sir, I will do this project. So even Kaveriya sir was following me, like how your project staff will be following you for the projects. That time Kaveriya sir said two words, like one is a successful person can either be an entrepreneur or a researcher. He cannot be a job seeker. So make sure that you are not that person. That was his final words. Immediately after my farewell, our 10th or 15th day, we started this company, Catamaran Technology and Business Solution. We registered it. We started slowly and I was doing some trainings across colleges. Wherever consultancy projects or wherever industry consultancy doing projects we were doing. So finally, one day I met one windmill AMC contract person. He gave me one product, like the monitoring and controlling these windmills from remote is totally tedious process. Can you help me with the product? So that was the initial trigger. Even that was the first product of Catamaran. We built a product. We actually, every Saturday and Sunday, we sit under the windmills. Like Monday to Friday, work in boss. Saturday, Sunday, go to windmill. There will not be no food, no water. That his sound will be there. That will be irritating you like anything. There will be headache at night. So it was that was our first project. We completed that product. We made a product. Even we made a good enclosures with the branding. I even put his logo also and I have given to him. So then we started selling some 20, 30 numbers we sold. Then comes the real picture of the business. Like until then we were like an innovator or like a technologist where we only manufacture and we give it. So then finally we thought, then we couldn't get the money from the manufacturers. I mean, the users. We couldn't get the money. Like they are saying simple reasons. You know how as Indian mentality says drags the money. Because if a person who is owning a windmill means he is already a big businessman. He knows how to handle small chota boys like us. So he would say beautiful reasons for not giving money. So every day we'll go in morning, we'll come back in the evening. From morning to afternoon, he will be making us to sit in his reception. He will not be giving even a check. Sometime if there is a bigger amount, for 5-digit amount means he will give a big, check for 3-digit amount. If he is a 6-digit amount means he will give a check for 4-digit amount. So this was the manner we were pro. Then I thought like this skill is little lagging in us. We don't know how to sell or buy a product inside in India. So then we had a friends. When we started a company, no, I had a friends like 3 or 4 or 5 members who have been part of e-Yantra and other things like wherever technical competitions were there, we were there. So this the same team formed a company and we were working in different places. Everyone had a thought how to. Then I thought this windmill product will be a super success. Everyone, you are going to resign a job. You are going to come here. We are going to rock. That was the initial statement I gave. And I found that we are a team of 5 to fuel ourselves, because whatever what we are getting currently in the companies, we should at least use. We should get the same thing from the company. Then only we can survive. At least we will not get beatings from the parents. Actually, you know how opposition will be there from a parents to quit a job. That to a MNC job, that would be a very tedious process. That itself a 3 months process. You should know a course how to handle parents. I thought that there should be, we should be solving a problem internationally. I had been taking a list of the cousins and relatives who are in abroad. I took a list, contact list. I used to call them. I'll ask them, what are you doing? Any projects, can you outsource it to me? I will do it for you. First product, like we thought we'll solve for the security surveillance. There was an investor we got from an investor from Singapore. He was dealing with security manpower providing agency. Then he had a lot of problems with security industry. So then we started a solution, working out with a solution with video analytics. Video analytics is a solution is CCTV cameras. We get the feeds from CCTV cameras. No? Now, what are the CCTV cameras we are used? It's used only for as an evidence, not as an alerting systems. So now we are able to track this CCTV footage by using machine learning and deep learning algorithms. We are providing an alerting mechanisms. So what are the alerts we provide to say is like illegal parkings, car number plate recognition. We used to, we are totally controlling the total, say, this is mainly, our mainly more, our most of our products focus only on the condominiums, smart condominiums. Condominiums are the apartments which are located in Singapore. So we started with providing the video analytic solutions, then started slowly entering into the IoTs of the building managements and the lift controls, fire panels. We started to, whatever the security role does, we try to replace everything and we have put into everything into a place. Like we have created a big dashboard. Whenever you park a car in an illegal place, it will give you alert to the security as well as to you. Because we have your database already pre-registered. One college in Singapore, they were looking for a robo base, which we thought we will be developing. We took the project. And finally, actually, we built a base to them and with their money, but now we had a competency of building a robo base. So now we had a competency of building a robo base. Then we had another project where they wanted a little more application with autonomous navigation. We look for another search for the projects. Then we put up writings, we took videos, we put animations, everything, because we got those project and we developed the capability of doing autonomous navigation. Now, for the first time, we are building on our, here in between, we sold, for our survival, no, we sold some robots to KCD College. Here and there, we sold some of the robots, what we made, the miniature version for Indian base. So that is making our survival, like with our, some embedded solutions we provide, across from this IoT, the windmill, what we said, no, that is our survival. And we got some fundings from Singapore as well. Now we are developing a security autonomous patrolling robo, which we are planning to deploy by second week of May at Singapore. So for this, beta testing and the FRB moldings and other structures are in place now.
This is the kind of spirit that we like, the can-do spirit, you know, which will kind of persist. And eventually, if you keep on hammering away, right, things do happen. And this can-do spirit is very important, and this is the kind of spirit we want to encourage around our lab. So I'm delighted to hear from Muthu and others that the e-Yantra lab is a place that you could go and you feel energized.